Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. In this video I'm going to show you how to install Parallel on your Mac. This is Mac OS X. I forgot the number, the version number. What Parallel does is allows you to run Windows virtually in your Mac OS and your OS X environment. Yes, it's virtual, but it does work. So what you want to do, if you want to go to Google, type in Parallel. Hopefully I spelled that right. And I did not. There we go. So now that I spelt it right, I'm going to do Parallel download. So you click that. You could buy it or you could try it now. Now, I made the mistake a few years ago. If you just want to try it, just to play around with it, try now. So what I did is, I, when you buy a license, you're not going to get an installation thumb drive or an installation disk. All you're going to pay for is the license code. And yes, you can get this at Best Buy. So for my sake, I am just going to try it because I'm going to do something else with it as well. So you scroll down to try now. And you just click download now. And that is the trial center. There we go. And as you can see, now when you first install this, I know I made a video about this a while ago, but I had to delete it due to certain things. But when I install this, Parallels will automatically install the newest version of Windows. So, of course, it's going to install 10. Now, I'm mostly a PC guy, but I like using this. So I'm going to click download, and it's downloading. As you can see in the bottom left-hand corner here, it is downloading. So I'm going to open it. All right, as you can see, it comes up with this. This is what I like about OS X. It does that. And then if you go, because unfortunately with Windows, when you install something, it's going to go directly, when you double click and try to install it, it's going to run the installation. Mac OS X stuff pauses for a minute. It's go, do you really want to do it? But in this case, I really want to do it. So click install. And it's telling me, hey, this is not a native program. And yes, I do want to open it. So I'm going to open it. And now what we want to do is we want to accept. I've read the agreement before, that's why I pushed accept. Now, unfortunately, it's requiring me to enter my password because I have this account password protected. It wants to make sure that I am the one or the person that has permission to be on here. And now it's going to continue. And as you can see at the bottom, that icon that is jumping, that means that's a program that's currently being installed. Okay, so as I said before, it's going to download and install the newest. So it's going to download and install Windows 10. The license factor is through parallel. Windows thinks it is an actual PC. So we're going to install Windows. Now, you could skip and install your own, either 7 or 10. But in this case, for demonstration purposes, I am going to install Windows through parallel. And this is a full install of Windows 10. This isn't, you know, some modified version that somebody created. It is the full version. Now, unfortunately, the way my network is set up for this is I have a switch that's connected to another switch which connects to a different room. So this is my secondary switch, which is over there. I have it set up for all this stuff. So basically, the line that's plugged into the modem that's in a different room comes in, goes into my switch under my entertainment center, and then this switch is connected to that. So that's why I'm getting kind of wonky speeds. All right, we are almost done here. And it's 5.42 gigabits. That's why it's taking so long. Now, as I said earlier, you could skip this installation or use it. For a basic user, which is the average person, just do it this way because then it's the newest. You don't have to worry about it. You can even still get the Windows 10 updates through this. And I'll show you that. All right, so it's done, and now it's loading it. And it's going to load just like if it's on real hardware. And now we're going to go through the setup here as if it was on real hardware here. You notice it didn't say start or install, install now. That's because this is an ISO file that is downloaded. Let me see if I can make the screen a little bit bigger here. I cannot. Okay. So, just like in a normal situation here, it's installing, but it's going to do it really, really quickly because you're installing, basically what you're doing is you're, just like VMware, you're installing software on top of software. As you can see, it skipped a few in installing the updates. Just like VMware and real hardware, it's going to do the same thing. As per usual, it restarted and now it's going to go into actual Windows 10. It's going to start services. Plug and play, just like that. Also, just like VMware and real hardware. What you just saw was the command prompt. And here we go. And here we go, we are going to the desktop now. Now, the name, I named this computer Test. Even the two PCs and even the G3. I named all these Test because this is a testing computer. So if you need, so if you use your name, whatever that may be, it's going to pick that up. And just like VMware and real hardware, we're getting all the updates. And since this is a new installation, it's going to take a while for the updates. And there we go. Wait a few minutes here. I accidentally clicked something else, so it's going to be a little bit. It wants me to log in, but I am not going to do that, so I'm going to that's going to make me. Okay, so in this case, I've done this before. You have to sign into a Parallels account. So I'm going to put the information in, and we'll be in. All right, so I am in. You have privacy policy terms of use, which basically means don't do anything that could get you arrested. Don't do anything that could possibly impact somebody's privacy. That's all that is. Now, I've read this before, so. It's telling me it's fully installed, so we're going to click that. I'm going to minimize that. Exit out of that. Okay, so we are in. So now if I go down here, the startup menu works. It's not showing up yet, but it does work. So, Office, you can download that. So I'm going to show you if it'll let me. the updates. The normal updates will work on here. So I'm going to do updated security, just like the real thing. Oh, it's not activated. Okay. Oh, there we go. Remember, this is just a test. So I am going to check for updates here. And there we go. So you can still install the updates. So, as you can see, it's the new version. It's 1909. So while this is happening, I'll let it do it. There we go. So I just minimized it. That's going to take too long. Anyway, That's it for this video. Please comment, like, and subscribe.